Today, I'm going to show you how to build a crazy fast ESPHome mmWave presence sensor with sound support, presence count, and pretty much every sensor you wanted the Akara FP2 to have for just a fraction of the price. And if you're ready, let's go! To build this, we are going to need an ESP32 30-pin development board and a high-link mmWave sensor. I recommend for you to buy the sensor kit. That includes the PCB antenna for better coverage and the 4-pin wire, so you can just connect this to the ESP32 board. But to be clear, you just need the sensor. The Bluetooth functionality will still work without antenna, just with a shorter range. And instead of the 4-pin wire, you can just use a female-to-female Dupont cable. Just bear in mind that for this, you might need a hot glue gun to secure the cables inside the case. I will show you both installations. And of course, a USB-C cable and a 5-volt charger. And to protect the electronics, you are going to need the fixtSE DIY sensor case. This is a remix of the ESP32 room case and the Everything Presence light. It's a versatile pressure fit wonder, requiring zero soldering or specialized tools. Just snap the ESP32 board with the high-link sensor, flash it with ESPHome using our custom firmware, and voila! You created the foundation for your smart sensor. You can get the files directly from printables, or you can order it from our sponsor, PCBWay. They are not just any PCB manufacturer. They are the one-stop online manufacturer with 24/7 customer service. PCBWay provides lightning-fast PCB fabrication and assembly, along with offerings in 3D printing and CNC machining. They provide the easiest way to make your smart home projects come to life. Whether you're a student tinkering in your garage or a seasoned engineer working on the next big thing, PCBWay has your back. Thank you, PCBWay, for sponsoring this video. You can use the link in the description to get a $5 discount on your first order. Now, to wire it up, we are going to use this table. Let me show you. First, get the case. We are going to use the ESP32 housing. Put the board inside and just press for it to fit. Then connect the 4-pin cable to the sensor. And just push it a little bit. And now we need to connect this end of the cables to the ESP32 board. If you hold the sensor like this, the order of the cables will line up with the table. So first, let's connect the 5-volt cable. For this, just grab the ESP32 board and look for the beam pin. Then just connect it. Now let's continue with the next one. And connect this to the TX2 pin on the board. Now the next one. And connect it to the RX2 pin on the board. That happens to be next to the last one. And now to finish, just connect the last cable to the ground pin. And that's it. And now, if you want, you can order the cables using a zip tie or whatever you have at hand. And now it's ready to install. Just grab the case, put the joint inside, and secure it with the lock nut. Then connect the PCB antenna. The antenna goes right here. Just push it there. And then just peel this off. And now just put the sensor in the case. And you can paste the antenna right next to it. Like this. And now, to fully close it, you need to bend these pins a little bit. Just push it inwards. And then just press it to close it. And then just put the lid of the ESP32 board. And last, connect the base. And that's it. Now, if you don't have the 4-pin cable, you can use female-to-female Dupont cables. If you hold the sensor like this, the pins will be 5V, RX, TX, and ground. so you just need to connect the female cables to the pins on the sensor. Sadly, the pins on the sensor are a little bit shorter and they fell off pretty quickly. So for this, what we are going to do is remove the plastic part of the cables. I'm just going to use toothpick and one by one, just remove the plastic part. And now we need to connect the cables. First, 5 volts. Then our X, then TX, and at the end, ground. That's it. You can see that this way they hold better to the sensor. And if you want to secure the placement, you can use a hot glue gun. That will also help with the isolation now that we have removed the plastic part. And then just connect the other part of the cables to the ESP32 board. And that's it. You can use the hot glue gun to secure the parts like this. I put a little bit on the corners of the sensor, and some more to secure the connection to the pins on the sensor. And now I'm going to show you how to install the ESPHome firmware. For this, we have two options, with Bluetooth proxy or without it. So if you don't need it, just use the version without Bluetooth proxy. You can learn more about Bluetooth proxy in the documentation. Now, to flash the firmware, we need to connect the ESP32 board to our PC. For this, we are going to use the USB Type-C cable. Now, click on the version that you want, select the device from the dropdown, and click on Connect. Now, click on Install. Here, it warns you that all the data on the device is going to be erased. This is normal, just click on Install. And now, on my case, I have to press the boot button. Just keep pressing until installing appears. And then just release. Now, we just need to wait. And that's it. Now, click on Next. And here, we need to connect it to our Wi-Fi network. For this, just select the network from the drop-down, enter your password, and then click Connect. And that's it! Now, we need to add it to Home Assistant. For this, just click on the Add to Home Assistant button. Then, click on Open Link. Click OK, and if everything went well, we should see our sensor here. Then just click on it, and click on Submit, and then Finish. Now go to ESPHome, click on One Device, and that's it. Here we have control over one LED on the board, if you want to use it for some reason, and if you scroll down, you can see all the information that we have available from our sensor. Now, if something went wrong, let me show you some things you can try. For example, if you can see the device when you click on the button, you might just be missing the drivers. For this, just click on Cancel. And here you can find the drivers for you to install. Just download the drivers according to your device, install them, restart, and try again. Now, if something goes wrong while you are installing the firmware, try to disconnect the device, wait a few seconds, and then connect it again. Sometimes, after a flash failure, the device needs to hard reset before trying again. Another thing that might happen is that the message might get stuck on erase. If this happens to you, just disconnect the device, reload the page, and try it again. And if everything was successful, but when you click on the Connect to Home Assistant button, the device didn't appear, just disconnect the board, wait a few seconds, and connect it again. Sometimes the auto-discovery failed, so we just need to restart the device and try it again. And now I'm going to show you the easiest way to configure sounds. For this, we are going to use the Hi-Link radar tool. You can use any of these buttons to install it on your phone. Once installed, just open it, and wait for it to detect your radar sensor. Then just touch it, Now, to create sounds, just click on Set. Here, we have three options. The first one, deactivate sounds. The second one will only allow to detect movement on the created sound. And the third one will ignore everything on the created sounds. So, you can choose what options fits better to your needs. In my case, I'm going to select area detection. One thing worth mentioning is that the sounds can overlap. And then you can create your sounds. Once you're finished, just click Submit. And that's it. Now go back. And here you can see your newly created sounds. And now, to use it on your dashboard, we are going to use Plotigraph. To install it, just click on this button, click on Open Link, and then just click on Download, and Download. After it's finished, just click Reload. If this happens to you, just click on Cancel. And now, go to Overview. Here, click on Edit, then click on Add a Card. Here, look for manual. Click on it. Now, go back to my website. And here, we're going to copy the code for the custom card. Then, go back to Home Assistant, select everything, and just paste it. Then, just click on Save. If everything appears red, that's okay. Now, just go to Settings, Devices and Services, click on ESPHome, click on One Device, and here just click on the first sensor, click on the gear, and we are going to copy the base name. Now go back to Overview, click on Edit, here press Ctrl F, paste a name, and we are going to erase the last 7 digits. Now, on Replace, we are going to paste the same name. And then just click on Replace All. And now, click on Save. Now, click on Done. And from here, you can look at the sounds and the targets that the sensor detects. If you want to adjust this configuration from Home Assistant, just click on Settings, Devices and Services, ESPHome, click on One Device, scroll down, and from here, you can change the default settings and edit the sounds. Any change will reflect immediately on the card. And that's it. And now, if you want to automate with it, you can use the sensor light blueprint by Blackie. If you want to know how to use it, you can watch this video. For this, you will get a crazy fast ESPHome mmWave presence sensor that you can just connect and configure on Home Assistant. The code that I used to create the firmware will be available to the members of the channel and to my patrons. If you like my work, please consider joining the channel or becoming a patron, like Flip. And if you can do that, don't worry. Just remember to give this video a like and share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. I'll see you on the next video. Bye!